Listen, I know a lot of you guys are total weeaboos, which means that the odds are that for a lot of you watching, there is nothing more that you would love than to have your own anime waifu. The 2D girls, they do what the 3D girls simply can't. But there you are, stuck here in your flesh prison. So there's not all that much you can do about it except draw some doodles and get paper cuts. But somewhere out there, someone was living your dream. And that someone was a penguin. A Humboldt penguin in Japan named Grape-kun. It's the greatest love story ever told, but it's not one without heartbreak and tragedy. So sit back while I tell you the story of Grape-kun, the penguin with an anime waifu. This video is brought to you by the new Star Wars soap collection by Dr. Squatch. The collection comes in this dope box and comes with 4 bars of soap inspired by some of my favorite Star Wars characters, representing the light side and the dark side of the Force. You've got Obi-Wan Kenobi, Yoda, Darth Vader, and Darth Maul. And they really do seem to encapsulate the light side and the dark side through their scents, with the light side being smoother and fresher with zero grit, while the dark side bars have a bit of a spicier fragrance with a rough texture that makes them great for scrubbing and exfoliating. I tend to be more of a dark side kind of guy, and the texture of the dark side bars gets you a nice scrub, removes all that dead skin, but the Obi-Wan is probably my favorite just because the scent is noble. Now I go around telling people I'm as legendary as Obi-Wan Kenobi. Doesn't get better than that. This collection is a limited time only collector's item, so hurry and order your Star Wars soap collection by Dr. Squatch before they run out. Click the link in my description down below. In April 16th, 1996, the Hamura Zoo in Tokyo, Japan had a new arrival. A new baby Humboldt penguin. When he was born, he was identified only by the purple ring they put on his wing to identify him, so they gave him the name Grape-kun. Humboldt penguins, which are a species native to South America, particularly Chile, could be like humans in a lot of ways, particularly when it comes to their relationships with other penguins. One day at the Hamura Zoo, Grape-kun meets a female penguin named Midori, and his behavior is unmistakable. He bows his head and exchanges glances with her. He extends his head up, opens up his wings, and lets out a call. She reciprocates, and thus, now Grape-kun and Midori are a couple. Humboldt penguins tend to be monogamous. When they find a partner, that's their partner for life, and Midori was Grape-kun's partner for life. And unlike a lot of other zoo animals, they even got to travel together. In 2006, the Tobu Zoo completed their new penguin enclosure. But you can't have a penguin enclosure without penguins, so arrangements were made for some of the penguins from the Hamura Zoo to go to the Tobu Zoo. Grape-kun and Midori being among the penguins making the move. And at first things are going great, Grape-kun and Midori are adapting to their new surroundings, and they even have a son together named Hanpen. But here's where things start to go south. Hanpen was sent to the Edegawa Zoo to be raised by a foster mother. They never even got to see their chick, and this was a move made to prevent inbreeding. Although ironically, Hanpen would wind up mating with his foster mother. I guess he had 2 broken wings. There's no way to know for sure, but some have theorized that the separation from their chick had damaged the relationship between Grape-kun and Midori. But what really sealed the deal is what happened later in 2010. In 2010, Grape-kun got sick, and for the duration of his treatment, he had to be separated from the other penguins at the zoo, including Midori. But the treatment is a success, and Grape-kun has a long life ahead of him, and they return him to the enclosure. But when he comes back, something's changed. He returns to find that Midori has moved on with another male penguin, a younger male penguin named Denka. And in addition to finding that what was supposed to be his lifelong mate had abandoned him for a younger male, the rest of the flock also began to shun him. Once again, there's no way to know for sure what the penguins were thinking, but it's possible that this was because when he was taken away, they had believed he had died. So there Grape-kun was, stuck alone with all these other penguins who no longer wanted anything to do with him. Midori and Denka would have a chick of their own named Beer. This chick would not be sent to another zoo, but instead live in the enclosure with all of them. So for Grape-kun, it would be 7 long years watching all the other penguins around him happily live their lives. While he sat there, abandoned and alone. Every day, a reminder of the life he used to have and how things were supposed to be. But in April of 2017, everything would change. It was at this time that zoos across Japan began a collaboration with the anime series Kimono Friends. Kimono Friends tells the story of Japari Park, a zoo containing all different kinds of rare, legendary, and mysterious animals. And some of these animals become transformed into human versions of themselves, or friends. The series was a runaway hit beyond anyone's expectations, and it was believed that because of the show's popularity, the collaborations with the zoos would increase awareness about the animals and also bring more visitors to the zoos. And Grape Kun's home, the Tobu Zoo, would be one of these zoos. So for the collaboration, cardboard standees of the characters from the show would be placed all around the zoo. And in the Humboldt Penguin enclosure, the Humboldt Penguin character, Fururu, would make her home. From the very first day of the collaboration, visitors would notice the penguin staring at the anime girl. Noticing how much attention the penguin started to get, the zoo began to post about him and giving a little bit more of his story. His name is Grape Kun. He's 20 years old, an old man in penguin years. He really likes her. Now, of course, it's really easy to sit there and look at animals behaving a certain way and you got this urge to anthropomorphize them. But these observations, a lot of times, are just us recognizing patterns that aren't really there and don't necessarily reflect what's actually going on in the mind of the animal. But what would happen next would be unmistakable. One day, while looking at Fururu, Grape-kun would extend his neck up, stretch his wings out, and make a call. In other words, he was very clearly trying to court this anime waifu. Surely this was an absolutely baffling event for the staff to witness. But perhaps it was a welcome one for a penguin that was known to have such a sad past. So as this story spreads, the internet becomes obsessed with the weeb penguin with the anime waifu. All kinds of articles are being written about him, tons of fan art being drawn, and even the people behind the show are getting in on the fun, with Fururu's voice actress going to meet Grape Kun in person. Although, if we judge by the green line analysis, the 3D woman was simply no match for the 2D woman. But then, tragedy strikes. A troubling image surfaces of Grape Kun stuck behind the fence, separated from his love. Look at my man in penguin jail over here, imprisoned for the victimless crime of falling in love with an anime girl. Rumors began to spread that he had become so enamored with the cardboard standee that he stopped eating, which of course would lead to the worst people on the planet, the internet armchair veterinarians, to talk about how this is actually animal abuse for them to have the cardboard cut out there. But people began to think that he was put behind the fence so he didn't starve to death and they could feed him. The zoo would later clarify that he was eating just fine and the fence was put there so he wouldn't accidentally fall into the pool at closing. At other times, he was free to stare at his waifu to his heart's content. So for the internet armchair vets there, suck it, he was fine. So the collaboration between Kimono Friends and the zoos turns out to be a big success. Visitor counts are rising all over the place, especially at this zoo with people going from all over the place to come see Grape Kun. He had become a massive attraction with exhibits made just to spotlight him. But eventually, the promotion would come to an end. And what this meant is all the cardboard standees around the zoo would have to be removed. What did this mean for Grape Kun? What would happen to Fururu? Would she be removed? Would Grape-kun be abandoned yet again? Ultimately, it was decided it would be best if she remained there indefinitely even after the collaboration ended. And from that point on, they would only be separated one time. In the middle of September, the zoo staff became concerned that a coming typhoon might blow away the standee or destroy it. So they took her away for safekeeping, leading to one of the saddest images to come out of this entire ordeal. Look at that. His shoulders are slumped and he's just watching his waifu get taken away. Maybe forever, he doesn't know. But of course, it's better than the alternative where she potentially gets blown away or destroyed and he never sees her again. But of course, she would be returned to the enclosure after the weather improved. I don't like that bitch Midori. Grape-kun didn't forget about her. You know, it's kind of funny to think though, how through this story, there's definitely a lot of people who came to legitimately hate a penguin. And you do have to remind yourself that even though we're seeing all these human characteristics in the animals, it is still just an animal. You can't really get mad at her. And after all, as it turns out, 1/3 of female Humboldt penguins cheat on their mates. It's just the way it is, and don't even get me started on the penguin prostitution rings. So with his anime waifu returned to the enclosure, and with Grape-kun still as popular as ever, on October 9th, the Tobu Zoo announced a 2-week special event celebrating him. the Autumn Grape Festival, which would be held that November. This turned out to be a case of some of the worst timing ever, because the next day, the zoo would share some bad news. Notice of cancellation of Grapekun exhibition due to changes in physical condition of Grapekun. We will cancel the exhibition from today. Hururu also moved with Grape. We apologized for any inconvenience. They announced that day's Grapekun exhibition had been cancelled due to unexplained weight loss. But they did bring his waifu with him while he monitored his condition so he wouldn't be alone through the experience. Get well soon messages poured in and people were hoping for the best. But humble penguins rarely live past 20 years old and Grapekun was already 21 years old. And sure enough, the next day, the Tobu Zoo reported that Grape had passed away peacefully with his anime waifu Furu by his side. Several pieces of fan art were made of Grape venturing off into the afterlife with his waifu. The zoo even set up a shrine where people could come pay their respects in person. And Mine Yoshizaki, the character designer for Kimono Friends, would gift an illustration to the zoo depicting Grapekun and Furu together, with her now wearing a purple armband just like Grape. The standee of Furu in the penguin enclosure has now been replaced by this art of Grape and Furu together. In the grand scheme of things, Grapekun and his anime wife weren't together all that long, just half a year or so. A life longer and full of more hardship than the average penguin. He got the happy ending that so rarely happens in real life. And the story still continues to this day. The standee of Grapekun and Furu has attracted attention once more. Now, from a young penguin named Nekun. Look at him try to get up on that rock. Who knows what his intentions are? Perhaps he wants to steal Furu away like that bastard penguin Denka? Or maybe, you know, he's just a penguin and he wants to peck at the cardboard a little. But in any case, that is the legend of Grapekun. If you like this video, check out my video about Hello My Future Girlfriend. I'm out.